Liver cancer, it affects one in every 35,000 people each year. Known as hepatocellular carcinoma, or HCC, it plagues men slightly more than women, but remains a disease our next guest is determined to help conquer. Joining us to talk about novel outpatient treatments against liver cancer is Dr. Maureen Kohi, an interventional radiologist at the University of California, San Francisco. Doctor, welcome. It's so great to have you back in the studio with
us. Thank you.
You know, what do typical HCC risk factors tell us about the chances of being diagnosed with liver cancer?
So the most common risk factors include viral hepatitis, so okay. hepatitis B and C. So if you know you have that or a loved one has that, then you can have a higher chance of being detected and you can get screening for liver cancer. Obesity, type 2 diabetes, alcohol consumption, those are also risk factors. So if you're aware of that and if your doctor is aware of those risk factors, the diagnosis can be expedited as well.
From a treatment perspective, in terms of hope and help, what's happening now for those being diagnosed with HCC?
So the curative therapies for HCC include liver transplantation and also surgical removal of the tumor. But the problem is that not everyone diagnosed with HCC qualifies for transplant or surgery. Mm. So one great novel technology is a liver-directed therapy with radioembolization, or such as TheraSphere. And this is a liver-directed therapy where we inject these small beads that are coated with radioactive material into the tumor, and that causes the death of the cancer cells. And so the tumor gets smaller, so the patients have more time to get a liver transplant, or the tumor gets so small that the surgeon can finally take the patient to the operating room and remove the tumor, and it will enhance their survival.
Well, that's great news, really.
Yeah.
And what makes this treatment preferable? I mean, I think I know, but say that for me again.
So I think the best part about the treatment is that it's an outpatient procedure. So you go into the hospital, you get the procedure. After a brief recovery, you go home. The quality of life is maintained, so you still get to wake up at your house and run your errands. And the hope of getting additional therapy afterwards, so if you need additional local regional therapy to the liver, or if you need surgery to the liver, is still available to you.
That is so great. And what are the criteria for successful treatment?
Usually what happens after the procedure, about 1 month to 3 months later, patients undergo some sort of imaging, either a CAT scan or an MRI. And what we hope to see is the tumor has shrunk significantly, and also it has died, so that the patients can either go on to have other curative therapies, such as liver transplantation or surgical resection.
What's the most takeaway information we can get?
Yeah, I think if you have HCC or if a loved one has HCC, it's important to know that there are a lot of different therapies out there, a novel therapy such as TheraSphere, radioembolization. So it's really important to talk to your doctor, ask them if you qualify or if you can talk to somebody that knows more about it.
Ah, such great information. Thank you so much for joining us today. And if you'd like additional information on this important medical and health topic, please visit us at thebalancingact.com or log on to Facebook/TheBalancingActFans.
TheraSphere, important safety information. Indication: TheraSphere is authorized by federal law for use as a humanitarian device in radiation treatment or as a neoadjuvant to surgery or transplantation in patients with unresectable HCC who can have placement of appropriately positioned hepatic arterial catheters. The device is also indicated for HCC patients with partial or branch portal vein thrombosis or occlusion when clinical evaluation warrants the treatment. The effectiveness of this device for this use has not been demonstrated. Adverse reactions. TheraSphere treatment has some common side effects, including mild to moderate fatigue, pain, and nausea, and may occur throughout the first week after treatment. Some patients may experience loss of appetite and temporary changes in liver blood tests. The introduction of microspheres into the vasculature of the stomach, duodenum, or other organs of the gastrointestinal tract may cause chronic pain, ulceration, and bleeding. Microsphere shunting to the lungs may cause edema and fibrosis that may not be reversible. For more details on rare or severe side effects, please refer to the TheraSphere package insert at www.therasphere.com. For more information, please refer to the package insert for TheraSphere contraindications.